Vlogmas day 4! Back to my channel. My name is Austin Betha and I'm really glad to have you here. Please do hit the subscribe button before you leave and also give this video a very big thumbs up at the end if you enjoyed watching. Okay guys, your baby girl here day hot videos back to back. Vlogmas day 1, 2, 3, today now 4. We two of the talk. Anyways guys, this is going to be a very serious video, so I need to be serious and I plead with you guys, please take this video seriously, because I mean, as much as this is a festive season and we ought to be happy, you know, just having fun and all of that, some people are going through stuff and I felt like it would be very nice for us to help ourselves out when we're in need. And today, one of us actually needs our help. I'm not going to mention her name because she actually begged me not to mention her name. You guys know how we do it on the Ask Better series, because from the title, you can already tell that that's why I'm here. So guys, on the 27th of November, I got an email from this anonymous Bethan, okay? And guys, it was such a long email. After reading this particular email, I was so sad. You know, I felt really bad. I wish I had this person's phone contact so that I could call the person. And guys, let me tell you, I kept on thinking about this email. I kept on thinking about what to say to her. You know, I spoke to some people about the issue. In fact, it was so heavy in my heart that I had to post it on Instagram. So if you're following me on Instagram, you must have seen the email I'm talking about, where I was asking you guys for your responses and all of that. If you're not following me on Instagram at this point, then I really don't know what we're doing. You know, I thought we were friends. Okay, so if you're my friend, you need to follow me everywhere. I'm going to leave my Instagram handle on the screen now so you guys can follow me, all right? Anyways guys, as much as I got responses from people that day, I felt like it's an Ask Better series, so it should actually be on the channel. I've just not had the time to film it, but then I decided, why not talk about it today? Like, what better chance do we have than talking about it today, being Friday the 4th of December 2020? All right, as usual, I'm just going to read out the email. I'm also going to insert it on the screen so you guys can read along with me, and then I'll give you guys the room to tell me what you think. Guys, please, I beg you, Ask Betha series is not where we joke. Ask Betha series is not where we insult anybody. Ask Betha series requires us thinking very properly, deeply, before we even place any comment. So if you feel like you don't have anything to say, that's fine. I mean, it's better for you not to say anything than for you to say something that's probably going to get other people depressed or just put them in a mood. All right, so before you place any comment here, I beg you, think about it. So according to the email, she said, "Hi Betha, I really hope this is the right email address. So I need an advice on what to do. Anonymity would be appreciated. I found out that my dad is cheating on my mom. My mom moved abroad 2 years ago, but my dad goes to visit her. You know the thing to kind of get the whole family to move abroad. So my mom volunteered to stay because she runs a business here and it's easier for her to close down her business and move than my dad, who works for the government and he's already at the peak of his career. So long story short, I found this out in July and it's November and the nonsense is still going on. I have had evidence that this is going on. You won't believe that my dad rented a house for this woman and furnished it for her. I swear, he is not smart. This woman is only using him to cash out. Not all my siblings know. Just 3 of us know out of 5, because the other 2 won't be able to handle it well. So I do not want this nonsense to go into 2021. So me and my siblings plan on finding out the woman's house so we could go there, warn her, and also destroy everything my dad got for her, and also video everything as an evidence for my mom. We would also report him to the church. Men are wicked though. My mom sends money home very well. Like, she made our life really better, and this is how this man wants to repay her. She volunteered to stay so she would work out how the family can move abroad, and this man is doing this. Can't he hold body till he sees her if he really wants sex that bad? Thinking about it, I feel like this can't be his first time doing such. What advice do you have? How do I approach the matter? I am 19 by the way, and my older sister is 22 and my younger brother that knows is 15. I really hope I get a reply soon because I want to act fast. I cannot watch this happen to my mom. I owe her this. One thing he also told the woman is that he is safe because my mom is not around and she is also a religious person that cannot use juju on the woman. But the children, we are religious but we can fight. He should not even try us. The battle that my mother can't fight. we will help her. That is why she has us. What is your suggestion? Now, while I was still trying to digest this email she sent to me, she forwarded me another email. So let me just read that out to you guys as well, okay? In this one, she said, in regards to the previous email, I just thought of something. To avoid getting in the middle and all of that, I am going to register two sims and threaten him with those two sims because he is scared of the woman's husband. I am going to be sending death threats to him because this man can fear so much. I would make the number private and send all sorts of threatening messages to make him scared. What do you also think? And guys, my first email to her was me trying to calm her down because I didn't want her to act irrationally and all of that. So I just sent her an email telling her to calm down, that I was definitely going to get back to her, which I did. Now, I'm going to tell you guys what I said to her towards the end of this video. But then let me just read out some of the comments that I got on Instagram so you guys can have an idea of the way people think and just about how they said they'll be able to handle this issue. All right, so this first person said, Betha, she should calm down. It's not a nice thing, but the truth is that she only knows what her dad is doing. Does she know what their mom is doing over there? She shouldn't confront her dad. Let her do it the way she said in the last mail, by using a new sim to threaten him, and they should watch if he would have sense. But she should be careful not to break the home, as in her mom and her dad. Alright, so that was what the first person said. Now this other person said, her mom did not ask for this fight. She and her siblings have no right to destroy the girl's stuff. If she bundles them to the station, she will be justified because these kids have no evidence. If their parents get separated, whose gain is it? They should mind their business and erase the memory. How is the woman married and he rented an apartment? This kid sharp. That's what this person said. Now this one says, Betha, please, to be sincere, it's very painful. Tell her to call her dad with her other two siblings to discuss the matter with them. Your parents are gods to you. She has to be careful on how to get involved in their business. Please tell her to erase the mindset of after all the mother had done. Alright, so that's what that person had to say. This one said, I'll fight the battle for my mom because telling her would only frustrate and worry her. Go to the woman's house, threaten her, and finish whatever she has. To some extent, involve a man of God who I trust to help with prayer and counseling. Now, this one says, it's difficult, really. I can only imagine. But the part of hiding her numbers, though, it's not so smart. I would tell my mom and advise her to stop sending money in the pretense that things are rough. He should use his own money and chase as many women as possible. Let her save money for her children's future or her retirement. Guys, to be honest, I can go on and on and on reading comments, but I want to hear from you guys. I want to hear from Bethans that are here. You know, just so that we can feel accountable for one another, because at the end of the day, Ask Betha series is where we all come together as Bethans, think collectively and help ourselves out. So that's why I felt like I needed to bring it here. Now, I know a lot of you want to hear what I think. Personally, I do not think that going to destroy the lady's stuff makes any sense, because destroying it's like, wait till you gain, you know. But I feel like she needs to sit her dad down and make him understand that, look, I know what you're doing and I have proof. So it's either you want me to do things my way or you change your ways, because at the end of the day, it doesn't even make sense. Yes, we cannot dispute the fact that we don't really know what her mom is doing over there, you know, so we're not going to be the judge of that. We're talking about the one we can see. And I feel like destroying things and all of that will not help in any way. So sitting her dad down with her siblings who are aware, talking to him and all of that, would actually make more sense, because then the man would know that, oh, these kids are aware, yet they chose not to report me to their mom. That's number one. It will make him have regard for his kids and respect as well. You know, secondly, it will make him know that, look, I need to be careful. Or better still, I need to stop doing what I'm doing. For me, I feel like his response is what is going to trigger my next move. So until I have a conversation with him, I cannot really say what my next move is going to be. Look, I know men cheat. Women cheat too. But then again, how can we handle this situation? Because these kids are really young. She's 19. Her elder sister is 22. Her younger brother is 15. So of course, the oldest person among them is 22. They need our help. Guys, let me know what you think in the comment section. Okay? I know this is not the usual fun laughing type of video, but every day not be Christmas, not 25th then be Christmas. Obviously, she's going to be reading through the comments as well. All right, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, well, I don't know if this is an enjoyable video, but I mean, if you watch to this point, thank you very much. If you're not subscribed to my channel, please do well to hit the subscribe button, give this video a very big thumbs up, and I'll definitely see you guys on the next one. Bye guys.